As I think I've well established at this point, a lot of the things that I talk about on this show are stuff that I either grew up with in my childhood, or I found interesting little tidbits to talk about that I thought would be interesting to share. While I'm not afraid to talk about things that I'm either not super into or not experienced as much as others, a lot of the stuff I get into is because I've got opinions on them. This week's episode isn't like that. This one's a bit more of a tribute. A walk down memory lane as we talk about the passing of one of my favorite actors, Dean Stockwell. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your ever-friendly Pokopoff, and welcome back to Fascinating Fiction. Though this time, considering we're staying within the bounds of reality, I guess you can call it more of a fascinating fact. Regardless, when it comes to actors in real life, I'm usually not the kind of guy who keeps up with who plays what or where they come from, unless they're either really big names, really prevalent when you saw them just about everywhere, or had major aspects on my life. Dean Stockwell is the latter one of these thanks to one particular role, but with his passing at the long-lived age of 85, I felt like that this was a good time to do a bit of a deep dive into his life, to see some of the roles he played and what he was known for, and eventually end off looking a bit into the series that I knew him best. Born in 1936, Robert Dean Stockwell had a family that were already big entertainers, with his father, Harry Stockwell, being well known for starring in some New York productions of things like Carousel in Oklahoma, as well as being the voice of the prince in Disney's Snow White. Being into this world of acting and entertaining was something that was always pretty big with Harry, so when he heard that there was a play looking for child actors, he took his son Dean and his brother Guy to try out for parts. Not only did they both get said parts, but apparently Dean was so successful that it led to a contract with MGM that eventually led him into appearing in movies. The first real movie that the young Stockwell ended up appearing in was a film called Anchors Away, which starred Frank Sinatra, Gene Kelly, and Katherine Grayson. Have you ever seen that clip online of a real-life actor that's dancing alongside Jerry from the Tom and Jerry cartoons? That's actually the same movie, with that particular moment being about Kelly's character telling a story to a bunch of young children, with Dean's character among them. He was also cast as the son of the main characters of the Thin Man series of films, which he had later said that he loved doing thanks to the fact that the main actors in those roles were sweet people and that he loved the little dog. Not everything was the best, however, as Stockwell would later go on to talk about the difficulties about being a child actor. There was a lot of work, and while there were a few films that he did that he actually enjoyed, he eventually ended up being known as both a very serious kid and not caring about the stuff he had become known for, like the bombed film The Boy with Green Hair. He said that he didn't have any friends outside of his brother Guy during that point of his life, stating that, and I'm quoting here, "It was a miserable way to bring up a child, though neither my parents nor I recognized it at the time." Kim is often considered the last real film that Dean Stockwell did as a young child actor, in which he focused on his schooling afterwards. And while he did have a lot of minor roles throughout the years after dropping out of college, including parts in things like The Twilight Zone and The Alfred Hitchcock Hour to name a few, he left show business again around the 60s and became a part of the hippie subculture. He didn't get back into acting until about 1968 and continued to do so for a good decade and a half. He didn't really get any big roles again until he ended up in supporting roles in Paris, Texas, and the film version of the classic novel Dune, which Stockwell mentioned that he felt like was a good start to a third career. He ended up being in a lot of roles after that, including being part of things like Murder, She Wrote, Beverly Hills Cop 2, and The Time Guardian. His biggest role, and the one that Stockwell said was among his favorite parts to ever play on film, was in Married to the Mob, where he played mafia boss Tony the Tiger Russo. The film was incredibly well received and was actually something Dean Stockwell went on to become nominated for an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor. And while he didn't win that award, several other functions did indeed reward him as Best Supporting Actor in their own categories. It was in 1989, however, that I believe that Dean Stockwell got the role that a vast majority of the people my age are most familiar with, and that was when he became Rear Admiral Albert Al Calavici of Quantum Leap. This was a show that was my first experience to the actor that would quickly become one of my most favorite characters. And since this is the one thing that Stockwell did that I'm the most familiar with, I hope you don't mind me gushing a little bit about the specific episode or two, because I'll freely admit, it's with the character of Al that I have become a better person in my life. Let me explain why. The first of these episodes I'm wanting to talk about in particular is Shock Therapy, for two distinct reasons. The characters within it are the first, as it's a bunch of people who are within a mental facility. This is one of the first times I was ever exposed to something like this on television, to be shown that just because someone is a little bit different, it doesn't mean that they don't have dreams, desires, or the will to try and improve themselves. The fact that it's Al who's the one who's having to help them is the second reason I was wanting to talk about this episode, since that wasn't something that he was normally able to do thanks to the limit of the show itself. It was a drastic difference from how Scott Bakula's character Sam normally handled things, and it showed a bit of compassion on Al's character. But it's the episode Running for Honor that I think had the bigger impact, since this episode actually shows Al in a bit of a bad light. You see, this episode is centered around the fact that Sam must prevent the death of another character who was expelled from his military school simply for being gay, and it shows here that Al does indeed feel like the expulsion is the right course of action. It takes the events of this episode and the horrors of seeing what happens to people in this era of history just for being gay that causes Al to change his thoughts and admit he was wrong. And this is something that was shown in 1992, where being gay was still a major issue. To see something like this was a huge impact on me, and is part of what eventually led me to change a number of the ways I saw the world, especially once I realized that there were members of my own family who also found interest in people of the same gender, and, I think, personally helped me on the road to realize my own pansexuality. If it wasn't for Dean Stockwell's character, I would not be the person who I am today. And while he would go on for many, many roles in both movies, TV shows, and even a cartoon or two, it was his role as Al that would always be something that I would remember, both for the lessons the character taught me, the hilarious anecdotes that we would learn about the character itself, and the sheer amount of personality that he gave to his role. He was, above all, a man who embraced life in a way that I don't think many people do. He wanted to give it his all, and while sometimes blunt, you can tell that he was there to encourage, help, and often get a laugh. He touched people's lives, and like the characters of Quantum Leap itself, even a single changed life for the better is worth it. We'll miss you, Dean.